What's going on, my friends? I am Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and we have a question. And the question is, next video, can you delve into why grounding conductors are often smaller than the grounded neutrals that they go with? Thanks for the hard work you put into your channel. You're welcome. So, let's break into it. Let's just, to start this out, for those that don't know, we'll go to Article 100. Let's read the definitions of each one so that we all know what they are. Grounded conductor, this is what we call our neutral, is a system or circuit conductor that is intentionally grounded. That is not the same thing as a ground that we call a ground out in the field. The thing we call the ground out in the field, the bare conductor or the green conductor, that's the equipment grounding conductor. Notice that there's an ing at the end, equipment grounding. And then there is grounded, which is the typically the neutral. An equipment grounding conductor, what we call the ground, is a conductive path or paths that is part of an effective ground fault current path and connects normally non-current carrying metal parts of an equipment together to the system grounded conductor or to the grounding electrode conductor or both. So the equipment grounding conductor carries fault current back to the grounded conductor or the grounding electrode conductor, the one that goes down to the ground rod, or potentially both of them. So there is a difference between them. A grounded conductor or neutral is designed to be a current carrying conductor, meaning that at all times it should have current on it. Now, if you have like this whole theoretically perfectly balanced system that we all seem to talk about in forums, which never exists, If you balance everything out and all of the loads are even and every breaker count is even and they have the exact same amount of amperage or current flowing through each one of the breakers on each one of the phases and everything is perfectly in tune and equal and balanced, then yeah, in some cases you're not going to have any neutral current. There's not going to be any current that's going to be flowing because there's no imbalance worth of current that neutral has to carry. So in that case, yes, a neutral may not have any current on it, but it is still designed to carry current. So a hot conductor has current going, and a hot and a neutral together to a light bulb, they're both changing back and forth. The electrons are getting excited. There's current actually traveling on it. So it needs to be sized to carry that constant amount of current. It can usually be reduced in size because we know that once we start balancing things out, that it's not going to have the majority of the amount of current that all of the rest of the conductors are if you've balanced the system well. But it still needs to account for a large amount of current flowing on it and flowing on it all the time. You could also have situations where you have nonlinear loads. You could have harmonics, you could have things where there's going to be an added amount of current in the neutral, so you can't reduce the size of the neutral. Some, you know, like single family dwellings and stuff, you can reduce the neutral size. So you can run two hots of one size, you can run a little bit smaller neutral, usually like one size less. That's kind of a rule of thumb, but it's not truth. Like there actually is calculations, 70% values and things that you have to figure out in code for a neutral reduction. But if you have three phase nonlinear loads where you could have this added amount of current building up on the neutral in excess of what each one of the ungrounded conductors or hots might have, then you need an upsized neutral. Another case where this would be the case is K-rated transformers. So there are transformers out there that specifically rely on there being an excess amount of current flowing on a neutral. So they actually make that conductor inside the transformer a lot bigger to be able to handle a lot more heat and handle all those harmonic currents that are going through it. So neutral conductors or the grounded conductors are intended to carry current, and that's why they have to be big. The equipment grounding conductor or ground should not be carrying current on it. It's really just a conductor that it has a conductive path, so if a fault happens, it can carry that fault current momentarily, very quick, split second, and it turns off immediately. So it's only going to carry current during a fault condition, and it should not be relied upon to carry current to keep a load running. That's what the neutral's for, or that's what the two hots ungrounded conductors are for. So the equipment grounding conductor is a lot smaller because it's never intended to have current on it. But if it does have current, it needs to be of sufficient size to be able to handle the fault current without damaging the insulation around that conductor, even if it is like a slightly sustained amount of ground fault current. If the, you know, if it's a long length or something where that's going to be like on and energized for a second and then shut off. So it has to be of sufficient size to be able to handle that specific purpose. So typically, if you look at the values for conductors, a lot of people, like old school cats, would be like, well, you just size your neutral one size less than your hots, and then you size your ground two sizes less than your hots. And in some cases that's accurate, but that's not truth. So equipment grounding conductors, just again for those that are not in the know, if we go to Article 250 in our National Electrical Code, this is the 2020 code, we're going to Table 250.122. So Article 250.122 talks about sizing equipment grounding conductors and just talks about procedurally what to do, everything with equipment grounding conductors specifically. So for grounds, we are looking in Table 250.122, and you'll notice that the size of the equipment grounding conductors are based off of the breaker size. So right, we run a circuit from a breaker out to a load. We carry an equipment grounding conductor with those to that equipment. We are grounding that equipment. So we're always sizing that conductor based off the breaker size, just like we do with the ungrounded conductors, you know, the hots, or hots and neutrals. We're always sizing like number 12 or 12 AWG wire off of a 20 amp breaker for the most part. There's derating factors, there's reasons why you might upsize or, you know, whatever. But for the majority of the time when we're running a number 12 conductor, we're running it on a 20 amp breaker. The wire is figured out off the breaker size, really off of the amount of current going through it, but we use that breaker size to determine whether or not the breaker and the wire actually match. So same thing with the equipment ground that goes with them. We use the breaker. So just remember, grounds always go off the breaker feeding that piece of equipment. Grounding electrodes are a little bit different. So grounding electrodes are sized not off the breaker size, but they're sized off of the actual conductors coming into the panel. So if there's a fault, if there's the amount of available fault current at that point, because those are large conductors, right? Those, if they short out, there's a lot of current that can go through those before something crazy happens. And so we need to have a conductor that's based off of the available fault current that could happen at that location, not off of any breaker size. So that's the differences between them. But the neutral itself is always going to be carrying current. There is a part in 220.61, feeder and service neutral load. So if you do want to figure out how to reduce your neutral size or calculate your neutral size, if you want to reduce it, if you can or if you can't, all of that is going to be in 220.61. And that's specifically in the standard method. There is also mention of using 220.61 to reduce neutrals within the optional method as well. It's still, you're still able to do it. You just have to read a little bit about that. But that is the reason, because they're not the same thing. A lot of people think grounds and neutrals are the same thing. A ground is just like a backup neutral. No, neutral supposed to carry current all the time. It's actually running loads. It's light bulbs running through it. There's all kinds of current going through neutrals all the time. There are some instances where there might not be current flowing on a neutral because it's a perfectly balanced system, and then current is taking a different path to still complete the current, but it's going through multiple loads, so it's still the same amount of power that's going through everything. But for the majority of the time, there is always going to be current on that neutral, and that's why it has to be bigger. So let me know if you guys have any other questions. I'm gonna keep doing videos all year long, just going to the comment section and answering all your guys' questions. So get them while they're hot. Love you, crazy people. See you in the next one.
Best can't use it and video.